exceeded the pot time on the sealer. That's what happened there, and dried up. So I cleaned everything out, made up a fresh batch. Let's try again. got you back on for the rest of the sealer there, but looks like it went on pretty nice. I don't see any traces of those red lines anywhere. It's nice and clean, shiny. Everything came out okay. There's a little bit of crap here and there. We haven't wet down the floor yet. We're still debating if we want to, because I don't want my hose getting wet. Ruby red base coat. It's reduced 20%.
episode.
All right, so we were just discussing all the trash in it. A lot of crap in it. It was unfortunate. Some of that was from the sealer. Some of it came into the base coat. But we're just going to keep going. Hopefully it'll be buried when you put the clear on it. You won't be able to see it. Pops thinks this is metallic flakes sticking out. It might be some truth to that. I don't know. We'll see. Well, I tried fixing some blemishes, and I think I made them worse. The crater right here now. These came out okay, I think. And then I found a run over here, which I tried to fix, and then when I painted over it, I put another run in it. So, you can see I took the wax and grease remover and just wiped the whole thing off, and so we're going to start over on that one. We'll give you the walk around after the first coat of base, though.
Looks pretty good.
I think most of that trash that I was seeing was actually from the sealer. I've never had that much trash in the sealer before, so I don't know, but you can see that looks pretty sharp there. As I was telling Pops, you know, it's a garage paint job, so it's going to have trash in it. There's not much we can do about it, so we're just trying to minimize it. Found right here, this didn't get sanded properly. There's a little lip right there. That sucks. Haven't seen that anywhere else. I can see it here, too. That goes all the way back to one time we epoxied or something there. And as much as we've sanded that and you think it's gone, nope, it's still there. Hopefully once it's all flow coated and we wet sand it down or everything, you won't be able to see that. But. All right, so I'm gonna let these flash off a little bit, then I'll put another coat on. Oh, that reminds me. I need to take off the, these guys. So we're gonna pull all those off. You don't have to come along for that ride. Sitting here watching paint dry. Car's looking really good. Bodywork's looking pretty clean. It's looking good. There's a few blemishes in it in the base here. There's one, some big chunk of something fell in it. I took it out with the tweezers, but I left a little puddle there. I don't know if I want to try and fix that or not with all the trouble I had earlier, but we'll see. I might go look at that, and that place where I had to run, I gotta put a lot of paint on that, because basically I went all the way back to sealer, so I gotta get that thing covered again. But, looking good. Alright, I had enough base to do three coats, so I did three coats. This is what this looks like, so 1500 grit. I keep finding big chunks in here, trying to get out. I wipe it off with a tack cloth, that seems to work the best. I'm gonna spot some paint in on those. I'm gonna do the control coat. Two control coats. like it came out okay, but so this is kind of the finish we're looking for here. I don't know how well you can see this, but it's gonna be nice and uniform. It's still wet here, but when it's dry, it should look real nice and uniform after the control coat. Look around the other side, the trunk here. Good example. All right, we'll do the other control coat, and then it's on to mid coat. All right, who's ready for some mid coat? It's Birdie. It's Candy. Vibrance VM4350. I hope I have enough of this stuff. I'm kind of low. We'll see.
Right when I
was ready to go,
and there's big hair in it.
I put some touch-up paint in it. All right, I used a detail brush to dab some paint on it. Hopefully that's okay, and hopefully the clear will bury that. I already cleaned up the gun and put away the base coat and everything, so I'm just gonna live with it and see what we get. If nothing else, it'll be, yeah, I painted that in my garage.
In case you were wondering, the hinge started giving us crap on this door. That's why it makes that awful noise when we close it.
quite sealed properly on the cup, and a couple of little drops came out. I'm not sure how to fix that. I'll ponder this for a moment. It's the first layer of mid coat, so I might be able to fix it. But what to do? I don't know if that'll be a good idea or a bad idea. I just wiped it off with a drop or a cloth. And I'll come back and touch it up and see if I can fix it. That sucks.
Oh, my next mistake. I'm gentle with my paint too. I think that's gonna be okay. It didn't transfer anything to my paint suit, so I think it's all right.
Found one more drip right there that I missed, but that's under the spoiler. All right, so this is two mid coats. You can see how these things came out. They're very lumpy, but that'll sand out. The color's not too far off. It's not great, but those will be visible. Like ass. Let's do that. Or shit. I don't know where this stuff is coming from. Oh well. As I say, you will know that it was painted in a garage. But all in all, the clear is going on really nice. Not really having any trouble. There's a lot of trash in it, but that's why we're gonna low coat it. That's looking good. All right, one more mid coat and then a coat of clear and we're done. Man, this is just so wild. Over here by the fan, man, this is where all the dirt is. And all that crap, big, heavy black stuff. I never understand where that crap comes from. It's gnarly. All this schmutz. So, I can flow coat it, but that's not gonna go away. You can't get rid of that stuff. Okay, she's done. And again, I wish the camera could do it justice. It's so much darker in person than you see here. Clear laid out pretty nice, the thing as you can see. Except for all of this trash. I don't see anything that went wrong in that last coat. These things aren't too bad. You'll probably see them pretty prominently in the sun. Little mark right there. But he's good. All right, so it is now 11:05. So I'm gonna come down, go take a shower and stuff, and then I'll come down after half an hour or so and unmask the stuff that's touching paint. And I'll shoot some video. Okay, here we go. She's done. Wow, what a day. It is now 12:30 at night. I must say overall, I'm very happy with how it came out. There's these problems that we talked about, like the drips that got in it, which, they are what they are. Can't really fix that. The clear came out really nice. And you can see there's trash in it, but like I said, we're going to flow coat it, so we'll be able to take care of most of that. I'm hoping you can see how rich it looks. Everything came out very nice. Very nice indeed. All the masking seemed to have worked as it was supposed to. Is there a place I can get a shot? Here's where we did the smooth transition tape right there. Can't see very well here, but it's okay. I don't see any problems with the paint. So, the application went really well. We had the drips and the trash, but other than that, it went perfect. Like no runs in the clear, which has always been my nemesis. It went on with pretty good texture. Look at that. Well, I'll say.
But this trash, oh my God, what is this stuff? Oh, hopefully you can see that, just brutal, big black chunks. And they're all right over here on the front of the car. So I just don't know what that is. Maybe, you know, something about, you know, when you first start spraying out of the gun after it's been cleaned, it's got something in it, I don't know. I can't tell, but the paint looks really uniform. I don't see any mottling, I don't see any stripes. Well, that was certainly a big concern of mine. You look at the hood, I don't see anything. Yeah, until it's in the daylight, you'll never know. And unfortunately, I can't drive this thing, so I can't pull it outside to show you. And my driveway is sloped, so if I put it out there, you know, I could use my winch to get it out there, but we may not be able to get it back in, and that would be bad. Oh, shit, that's not supposed to be there. Fuck me. Ah, hang on. Well, that wasn't supposed to be there, so something flipped up in it when it was done. That's in the clear, though, so we'll be able to bust that out. Yeah. Also, I'm going to take a step back here. Play with the exposure. That's actually pretty good right there. I'll darken it down a little bit to try and... That's closer to what it actually looks like right there. You see how pretty and dark that is? It'll hold the exposure there. Yeah, that's closer to it. It's a little dark, but that's about right. Get a better shot at it. Of course, it's metallic, which you can't see in here, but all right. Marathon day. Sorry I didn't get it out on Friday. It's now Saturday, but we'll post it for you. It's going to be an uber long video. Well, you know that already if you got to this point. So thanks, everybody. Can't thank everybody enough for all your help. I could not have done this without all my YouTube buddies. Yeah, especially all you painting guys. Really appreciate all the help that you've given me along the way. Everybody, but especially the painting guys. You gave me the confidence I needed to do this. And, you know, if I'd been in a paint booth, this probably would have been perfect. But it's not. It's in a garage. So it is what it is. All right, I'm going to wrap it up here. I'm exhausted. I'm going to go inside, post this video, and go to bed. Adios!